Hello everyone. In my last videos, I have discussed about the bones, the joints and the ligaments of the foot. So today in this video, we will move from the bones to an organ that is like some other part in our body, mainly a organ that is very important in our body, that is the heart. Okay, heart, we all know this is the main organ for the circulatory system. So we will not read about the whole circulatory system, but we will just try to understand about what happens to the blood in the heart, how the blood gets pumped out to the body, how the deoxygenated blood is converted to oxygenated blood, and so on. So to know all this, first we have to know certain basic things about the heart. So coming to the heart, we will see there are four chambers present in the heart: the right atrium, the left atrium, right ventricle and the left ventricle. These are the four chambers. Okay, then the valves, we get four valves in the heart, that is mainly divided into two. One is the atrioventricular valve and another one is semilunar valves. The atrioventricular valves, that means it is present in between the atrium and the ventricle. The semilunar valves, it gets its name from its shape. The valves are, when they occur, they are into the semilunar shape. So the atrioventricular valve is of two types. One is tricuspid valve, one is the mitral valve or the bicuspid valve. Okay, now in the right side of the heart, we will find the tricuspid valve, and in the left side of the heart, we'll find the mitral or the bicuspid valve. The name itself suggests tricuspid, that means the valve has cusps. Okay, it has three segments, cusp. Okay, like it will open and close like this cusp. Okay, so there are three cusps in the tricuspid valve, and in the bicuspid valve there are two cusps. In the semilunar valves, we'll find the semilunar valves in the pulmonary valve. We will see that the pulmonary artery is taking the deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Okay, and at the beginning of the artery, we'll find a valve that is a pulmonary valve, and there is an aortic valve, aorta, which takes the oxygenated blood from the heart to the body. There we find a valve that is the aortic valve. Okay, next in the diagrams, we will find certain structures marked with the blue color pen, that will be the deoxygenated blood, and we will see certain structures which are marked with the red color pen, that is the oxygenated blood. Okay, now certain important things we can see, that is, we all know the artery carries the oxygenated blood and the veins carries the deoxygenated blood, but in case of the heart, it's contrary, that means it is opposite. Okay, the pulmonary artery, it carries the deoxygenated blood, and the pulmonary veins, it carries the oxygenated blood. Okay, in case of heart, it is opposite, always remember this. Then we can see there are the vena cava, like the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. The superior vena cava drains the deoxygenated blood from the body to the heart. When it is said that it is superior, that means it is carrying the deoxygenated blood from the upper part of the body. Okay, and the inferior vena cava, this is draining the deoxygenated blood from the lower part of the body to the heart. Okay, and there is the aorta, which is a very big artery. It supplies the oxygenated blood from the heart to the body. This is the main artery which pumps from the heart to the body. Okay, now next, coming to the diagram. Okay, so now coming to the diagram, we can see there I have drawn two types of diagrams. Okay, one is the diagrammatic representation of the diagram, which we always see in the books, and this is in a simplified way which we can understand what is the heart and how it is functioning. Okay, so firstly we can see in this diagram, this is the right atrium, this is the left atrium, this is the right ventricle, this is the left ventricle, this is the septum which divides the left side and the right sided heart. Okay, this is a valve. I have said that this is the tricuspid valve, that's why I have drawn three. Okay, that means it has three cusps, and here it's a mitral valve or the bicuspid, that means I have drawn two cusps. Okay, so these two are dividing the atrium and the ventricle in between them. Okay, then we will see we have this pulmonary artery, here we find the pulmonary valve. Okay, and this is the aorta. Okay, in the left ventricle, this is the aortic valve present here. This is the inferior vena cava, which is draining into the right atrium. This is the superior vena cava, which is draining into the right atrium. Okay, this is the aorta, which is taking the oxygenated blood. It is going up. It's a very large artery. It is carrying the oxygenated blood. It goes, it gets divided to supply our upper part, and then it goes, turns and goes towards downwards, which again divides and supplies our abdomen and the lower part, and so on. So when we see about the circulation of the heart, we will see we need the heart as well as we need a lungs here. Imagine there is a lungs. So what happens? The deoxygenated blood from the lower part is coming through the inferior vena cava to the right atrium, and the deoxygenated blood from the upper part of the body is coming through the superior vena cava and is draining into the right atrium. Okay, now the blue lines, you can follow the blood. What happens when it enters? This is blocked. Okay, and then when this right atrium contracts, this opens, and the blood from the right atrium, it flows to the right ventricle. Now when the blood flows here, immediately this gets shut. Okay, otherwise, so as we have seen, when the blood pumps into the right ventricle, immediately this gets shut up. Okay, otherwise what happens when the right ventricle will again pump, or it will contract, the blood will have a backflow. Okay, to prevent this gets shut immediately. Then when the right ventricle constricts or it contracts, the blood is pushed through the pulmonary artery. Okay, it is pushed through the pulmonary artery, and the deoxygenated blood, it goes up and goes to the lungs. Okay, this is all the deoxygenated blood. So as we know, in the lungs the blood gets purified. Okay, so in the lungs, the blood, the deoxygenated blood gets purified to oxygenated blood, and from the lungs again the oxygenated blood comes through the pulmonary vein. Okay, this is the opposite thing which I have mentioned earlier. Okay, the pulmonary artery is taking the deoxygenated blood, and the pulmonary vein is bringing the oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart via the pulmonary vein. Okay, it enters the left atrium. Okay, now the left atrium contracts, and then the bicuspid valve, it opens up, and the blood flows into the left ventricle, and immediately when it flows here, it gets shut. Okay, because now when the left ventricle will contract, otherwise the blood will have a backflow. So now it shuts immediately, the blood is here, again the left ventricle contracts. Now the left ventricle pushes the blood through the aorta. Okay, this is the main branch, this is the main artery which gives the oxygenated blood to the body. So the blood flows through the aorta, it goes higher up, it is the arch of the aorta, this is called the arch of the aorta. It goes higher up, gets distributed to the upper part of the body, and then through the backside of the heart, actually it gets again divided into different branches which gives the oxygenated blood to the abdomen, and then later it comes down to the lower limbs. Okay, so this is the circulatory system, or the circulation of the blood flow in the heart. Okay, so in this diagram we can see in very brief. Okay, imagine our heart is a box. It has four chambers. Okay, this is not diagrammatic representation, it's just for explanation purpose. So if we see, there are two vena cavas which drains the deoxygenated blood into the right atrium. There is the valve. From here the blood comes here to the right ventricle. Again from here it goes to the lungs. The deoxygenated blood goes to the lungs. Okay, now again from the next chamber, what happens? From the lungs, the oxygenated blood comes to the left atrium. From the left atrium, again when this contracts through the bicuspid valve or the mitral valve, the blood comes to the left ventricle. Again from the left ventricle, we can see this is the aorta. From the aorta, it goes out to the body. So this is a very brief diagram of what happens to the blood in the heart. Okay, so hope you all have understood the circulation of blood in the heart, how the oxygenated blood is coming from the lungs to the heart, and the deoxygenated from the body is coming to the lungs, and the circulation goes on. Thank you.